elements of the movie are closer to our reality, so the audience can rely to the humanity and to the drama of the characters. And the Ornithopter is one of the elements that I choose to go in that direction. In the book, it's described as kind of a plane that uses a propelling system that looks like a bird. Ornithopter. It's like a kind of challenge to bring that to the screen because it can either look fantastic or very silly.
I love how kind of childish everyone is when it comes to talking about these incredible things, ornithopters that look like flying bugs and beetles.
To make this a reality, we started back in February 2018 with Denis, and George Hall came along. And then we conceptualized this first version of the Ornithopter. We had insect references, we had bird references, we got helicopter references. And then as we went along, we had like more angular references for the world of Dune.
The biggest challenge was Frank described something that flapped and, you know, this futuristic propulsion on Arrakis. I think it was because of the outlawing of thinking machines, so he wanted something kind of low-tech. So I would start doing these little sketches and then start kind of really designing the mechanics of it first and then making that into a shape. What I have in front of me are some examples of my final Ornithopter illustration. But the process goes from sketch to drawing, then I will model it in 3D, then come back to drawing, get notes from Denis that may be more otherworldly or more functional.
I was trying to get closer to the idea of an insect instead of a bird, because there will be a feeling of power and a feeling that will look more realistic. We were getting closer to a dragonfly cross-mix with a helicopter.
Technically, it flaps its wing, but ours is just like a very, very fast movement, almost like a vibration, just like a hummingbird or a dragonfly.
I worked with Patrice and also another artist named Coley Wirtz, who took from my beginning designs and took it to the next level, where, you know, really figured out all the details and worked with BGI to build them full size on set. We had to figure out every nut and bolt on this thing for the actors to be inside and out.
They've been constructed in such a way that when you're next to them, the amount of detail that they have is amazing. I was just blown away, really.
I said to Patrice, I want them to look as real as possible. I want my mother to believe that this thing can fly for real. I want it to obey to gravity laws. I want it to feel muscular. I don't want it to be necessarily elegant. I want it to be like bulky and powerful machine that looks like a military helicopter.
These machines, they work in two extreme conditions on Arrakis. There's winds at 850 kilometers an hour. So you cannot have something that is small and very delicate. They need to be tough, you know, and they are beasts, you know, they're big, especially when they were indoors in London. They look huge and quite impressive. The wingspans are 129 feet, and this one is 75 feet long, and 11 tons, which created its load of problems, because they need to be on cranes, they need to be flying.
Sir, stand by to go, guys, please.
Worm sign warning, acknowledge.
Who calls Delta Ajax Niner?
So Denny wanted these scene to be shot in IMAX. This is why the cockpit is in tears, because when the cover is not there, you see the world in there. Also, because of the angles of the glass, you're totally submersed by the desert. It's also to give the spectator an interesting point of view.
I think of the excellent skill level of Patrice at the Ornithopter, which felt like a real thing. It felt like, you know, something that you wanted to strap into, you wanted to put your seatbelt on.
The job in CG was to add any wings, especially if it needed to animate to open up and then to fly. And there was a lot of work done in animation to get a range of motion as to how this Ornithopter flies, because obviously there are some dramatic scenes where, like, you dive down and it's highly maneuverable. And also, like, you have people like Duncan Idaho who, like, you wanted to give it like a certain swagger as well as he flew. One thing which we did do to try and keep things believable is that we did a lot of helicopter work. The idea being that you'd have your camera helicopter shooting an Ornithopter, you know, and that way, like, you then use lenses specific because, like, you're actually shooting it for real, you know. And, like, you never get too close that, like, you never get any of those CG shots, which are highly unlikely.
There's so many ideas in the movie that are complex. or foreign or strange, that I wanted the audience to have some crown at some place so they can feel some kind of familiarity. And we came up with that shape that I deeply love, that is very unique.